the shade, the shade.
I can't. It's how people be like, no, I'm all like, let's
I mean, from one queen to two other queens. They both hail from Durban and they are now two of South Africa's most prominent actresses dominating on the global stage. We can't have talent like this on Espresso Studio and not pick their brains about what it takes to make it big internationally. Once again, everybody, I'm talking about Nomsa Mombatha and Pearl Tusi. Yeah.
Are you from Durban?
I'm not from Durban,
because they say hailing from Durban. Actually, it's like in Durban, in KZN, Durban is the whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
I think they should just rename KwaZulu-Natal.
Umashu falls under eThekwini, actually.
I mean, I'm not from
eThekwini. When we
No, even worse, Mpongengezi, next door to Hillcrest. I came from the one Hammersdale. Oh, God.
I'm not from Durban. I'm from, okay.
But you're from South Africa. We're from South Africa.
KZN. Something in the water.
Girls, you are dominating on an international level. We spoke about this briefly, but Nomzamo, for you, do you feel like South Africa is getting recognized more now, or are we bringing South Africa to the international stage?
What,
tell us about it.
To be honest, I think what the internet has become in the way that it's so robust, it's that it's made the access to entry, the borders to entry as well, just so much more that accessible. You know what I mean? We're able to see what's happening globally, so people are just becoming more and more aware. You know, so it's just really just a marriage of different worlds coming together. It's incredible to see, because it's not just South Africa, but it's just like the African continent.
Absolutely.
You know, and if you look at so many things, from music to pop culture and your art scene and also film, everything is, a lot of things are influenced by Africa.
Yeah.
You know, so now it's just a matter of actually buying the ticket, landing on this African soil and building some infrastructure and shooting some things.
And speaking about shooting some things, and on that note about, you know, Africans telling African stories, Queen Sono, hello. Why do you think it's so important, for example, you guys being on an international scene to pave the way for other actresses who are looking up to you?
I think for every generation, there's always been someone who has to pay the price. And for me right now, one of the most important things is to actively fight for women to get paid for what they do. We've had this conversation, Nana. I think it's just really important that the narrative that we bring out, that what we talk about, what we do, is going to really change the face of what we're doing in this country. So I feel for me, like, to uplift women, to uplift each other and tell the right stories is going to really, really change the face of what we're doing, and to fight for a better industry. For me, like, the industry that we're creating, we've had Miriam Makeba fight for Go to Exile through her music. I know of artists that we've worked with, like Zone 14 for me, and I think On Inspire with You, similar actors who would walk kilometers and kilometers and kilometers just to get on stage, get paid very little because of the passion for what they did. And I think now it is our turn to now make certain sacrifices and break certain boundaries and glass ceilings and actually create our own limits, if there are even any. So I'm not here now to look at the glass ceiling and see how I'm going to break it. I am now here to create a special space where women are going to decide what they want to do for themselves. Like, for me, I don't want to be the first black anymore. I don't want to be the first woman anymore. I want to be the first person to do something. So I think to teach young women, especially young black women, how to do that, or that they can do that, is what's really important.
Exactly, cementing yourself. It's like each generation is faced with different scourges. I mean, the previous generation was liberation and they achieved it. And you always say you're living out your ancestors' wildest dreams.
Absolutely.
And that's exactly what's happening. As you rise, you lift, you know, for the next generation.
But also leaving your generation better than you found it.
Yes.
You know, that's like my motto in life. I think it's now's the time. Now's just the time.
It's the black girl's
but
moment.
But also, like, just do you.
Yeah.
You know, like, completely, completely do you, and be courageous, be brave about your dreams. And whoever's watching is able to see that and be inspired by that. You can't be what you don't see.
Yes. Yeah.
Where to from here? I mean, like, you just branding, collaborating.
Are you coming to Africa?
Are you coming to America?
I just said I'm a digital nomad. I'm gonna move to Italy and just become a waitress.
It depends what the
but
vibes
where to
are.
From here, I think continuing to just really stand up for the most marginalized. Mm. You know, the work that I do with the UN, the work that I do with Cotton On Foundation, the work that I do with my foundation, the Lighthouse Foundation, continuing to tell beautiful, beautiful stories, human stories, above them just being African stories, but just human stories, and continuing to shape this little generation that I found myself in. Mm.
If no one has ever told you this, I'm gonna say both of you, thank you for paving the way forward for women like us, that's still up and coming, opening up the industry and making sure that you're commanding your space. It's lovely having you in studio with us. And I'm sure people are coming.
I want to give a big shout out to someone who actually, I believe, I don't know if she's inspired you, but she definitely was a huge inspiration and even big sister and mentor to me, Terry. Mm. I mean, if seeing Terry on that Oscar carpet did not inspire you, like when she put Leading Lady, she's an extremely huge inspiration to me, and I always want to make sure I recognize it. When I started doing RGB, I had no money, but I had all these events to go to, so I didn't have clothes, and the stylist didn't have enough clothes for me. Mm. I had she was cleaning out her stuff. She gave me two big black bags full of designer clothes that I could wear for events.
You know, that's Terry.
And I think it's important for us to share these type of stories about the women who've supported us, and I think we don't talk enough about it. Mm. So shout out to Terry Peto, shout out to Basi, shout out to all those women who supported us.
And shout out to you guys, firstly, for sharing your Cosmo platform with one of
upcoming.
Awesome.
And
staff,
also with you for just always being ready to respond to the DM girl, like, do this, don't
she's
do this.
You know? Like, I'm stuck, what do I do? I'm like, hold on, breathe.
Relax.
You stand.
Amazing. We stand you guys so much. Incredible women here in studio this morning. I'm talking about Nomsa Mumbata, Pearl Tusi, and Shoma Josie. Unfortunately, it's almost that time to say bye, but not yet.
We refuse. We will not leave.